I see a love that money just can't buy. One look from you, I'll drift away. I pray.
Hello, this is Greg Michael, and today we are learning how to play You Got It by Roy Orbison. I'm doing two lessons about this song. One lesson is for beginners and one lesson for more advanced players. This advanced version of this song uses a lot of bar chords, so this is a good workout for those of you who need to work on your bar chords, I guess, you know, or someone who, or those of you who already play bar chords and obviously they need a song to use them. The beginner version is the version with the cup on the second fret, and I'll do a separate video about this. Now, so this song is in the key of A major. The first chord is the chord A major. Then the next two chords are G major and D major. I play obviously bar chord version of G major, and then I go to D major with F sharp in the bass. So just regular D major, but with the F sharp in the bass. I kind of like this voicing, and I think it kind of works in the context of this song because of this moving bass line here. So after that you have A major, and then G major and D major again. So this is the chord structure for the intro, and the intro goes like that. So this thing is basically 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, 2, and 3, 4, and 1, 2, and 3, 4, and 1, 2, and 3, 4, and now the verse of the song, it's pretty much made of the same thing, but at the end the chords are changing, so I will show you. So it goes A, G, D, A, G, exactly the same as the intro, then A, G, D, E major, going to G major bar chord. I'll kind of try to sing. Every time I look into your loving eyes, I see a love that money just can't buy. So this is verse number one, and we have actually another verse in this song. And I will be posting the link to my chord sheet where you can see the chords, and you'll be able to see chords, you know, in bars, so you know exactly how many bars you have to play of each chord. So I on my sheet, you know, that thing that I've done was the verse. Then this thing that is coming up, I call pre-chorus. So one look, one look. So two rounds of the same chord progression that goes A major, one bar, F sharp minor, then C sharp minor, and then E major. When I play my C sharp minor, I actually bar this string as well to kind of prevent it from ringing. You know, that string can be dead, or you just kind of avoid it, but if you hit it, it's not going to be a mistake, because it's this note is part of the chord. So it's 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, 2, and 3, and 4, 1, 3 and 4 and 1, 2 and 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 3 and 4 and... Okay, so after that you have verse number 2, which from the chord structure point of view is exactly the same, so I'm not gonna talk about this anymore, because obviously you can refer to this chord sheet that you can find on my website. Now, pre-chorus number 2 has different lyrics to the first one, but the chords are the same. Which is, you know, he sings, I live my life. I live my life. That sort of thing, right? And then he sings chorus number 2. And the chorus number 2 is very similar to chorus number 1, but it's longer, because he sings 3 extra things. So he goes, so that's the regular chorus. And then he sings,
anything you want, anything you need, anything at all.
So it's kind of, you have to play extra E's at the end, you know, of that chorus. So let me talk you through the chords quickly. So it's A major to C sharp 7. I also kind of play the on the sixth string. Well, I kind of bar the sixth string, but I'm not hitting that string. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Then the next chord, F sharp minor, and then D major. So it's A major to C sharp 7, F sharp minor to D major. 1. So you have 2 chords per measure. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And at the end of that chorus, you always play A major. I chose to play open chord. 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1. 2, and 3, and 4, and 1. So what you do on actually each chorus, you play at least, well, you play those chords 3 times, and then you add A major for the whole bar, and then E major for 2 bars. So that's the regular chorus. Now the chorus number 2, it's longer because, as I was showing you earlier, you have to sing anything you want, anything you need, anything at all, as well as the previous things that he sings in every choruses, in all choruses. So you just kind of extend that chord progression by those extra E's. So each phrase, like anything you want, is made of 2 bars of E. So anything you need is another 2 bars, and anything at all is another 2 bars. Now there's this cool thing going on in the background when he finishes the chorus, and it's that walk down that goes like that. And I'll show you how to do it. So I will kind of try to play a bit of chorus in order to jump into that walk down in a logical way, so that it makes sense and you kind of know how to do it. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and, you know, it's kind of, you play your chorus, you know, 2 chords per measure. And then 1 bar here, 1 bar of A major, 1, and then on E major chord, when you don't play this those two bars of E major, you just hit the E once and jump to the note E, located on string 5 fret 7. You play twice, up down, followed by up down on the 5th fret of string 5, followed by up down on string 5 fret 4. Then we are moving to the lower string and do the same fret, up down, up down, up down, slide down to the 2nd fret, and then open E string. So it goes again. I'll take it this time from the chord A major. 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and... So I went to the next section of the song, which is the middle 8. And middle 8 is made of the same chord progression as the chorus. So when you look at the chord sheet, you will see, it will be very clear to you, you know, how to do it. And then you jump to the next section, which is pre-chorus, you know, and it goes, I'm glad to give my love to you. I forgot what's next, you know, doesn't matter. I know you feel the way I do, whatever. So the point is that the walk down has to be timed correctly so that you can straight away go to singing, if you are the singer who does the walk down. But obviously singing those lines such as anything you want and thing you need, it's quite tricky when you do the walk down at the same time. I kind of can't do it. So what I do, I play the chord E instead of the walk down. So listen, I'll talk you through this walk down again. The first walk down, as I said, kind of starts on the chord E major. If you know, I kind of arranged that for people who actually play, you know, acoustic guitar. So you know, if you play the chords for, you know, for other parts, you just exit that chorus and then play two notes, two stroke per notes, you know. So it's up down, 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 up down. Now listen, chorus number 2 has actually 4 walk downs. So what you have to do the second time, third, and the fourth time you do the walk down, you have to do 2 strokes on the E string. So it goes like that. You see? And then again. Sorry, I'm gonna stop. The fourth walk down is 1 stroke, you know. Because you have to jump to the next chord, okay? So just to recap, every chorus of this song has at least 1 walk down. So if you want to play the walk down, you access it through playing 1 strum on the beat 1 of chord E, followed by the walk down, and then you can continue with either the verse number 2, or you know, if you play the chorus number 2, it's gonna take you to the middle 8. That is just kind of another chorus, kind of chord progression. So it goes. Chord progression, and middle 8 chord progression, since this is the same thing as the chorus, it also has the walk down at the end. Now the pre-chorus number 3 is from the chord structure point of view the same as the first two. It has, as I said, the different lyrics to it. But after that, you have two more choruses to go. So the chorus number three of this song is exactly like chorus number one. So it has only one walkdown. And after chorus number three, you have chorus number four straight away. And the chorus number four has one walkdown less from the second chorus, because he sings less things. He sings basically anything at all, baby, and then you got it is actually on the new chord. So basically it goes like that. But if you are the guy to do the walk down, you obviously I'm gonna now play only the last round of the chorus. 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1. Did I play three or four walkdowns? I tried to play three. So if I played four, I'm sorry, but I meant that really three walkdowns. So the last walkdown. So the last walkdown has two notes here at the end. And then down, up, on, you got it. So what I want to say is this. You need to obviously learn the chords. You need to learn the structure of the song. I strongly believe that it's good to learn the song structure without the words, right? I think it's good to memorize the song and know how many bars are in each section of the song. It's good to see similarities between parts of the song, and obviously those great songwriters, they vary the parts, I mean the choruses or verses, just to make it more interesting so that you don't get bored by listening to it. And and listen, if you maybe learn the words first, because you know, if you are memorizing your words, you're actually learning the song. And it's good. You become more familiar with it. So it would be probably easier to learn the song on the guitar once you memorize the lyrics, and then you don't have to learn lyrics. You know what I've done? I've done something completely opposite. I've learned how to play the song first, and then you know I've learned the lyrics, and then the process was kind of a bit slower. So you know this is it. You know that's the way I played. You got it. I know that Roy Orbison played probably less bar chords during his live performance. You know, there is this YouTube video where you can see it, but as I say, I believe that I feel like those bar chords are nicer. You know, they sound better. You know, when it comes to performing this song. So I hope that you found some value in this lesson. And if you enjoyed the content of this lesson, you know, I would appreciate if you could hit the like button and subscribe for more videos if you are interested in learning with me. Okay, so thank you very much, and I will see you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.